Class 12. Well, in continuation with the chapter Methods of Calculating National Income, where already in my previous video I've explained you that national income is estimated by three different methods, that is value added method, income method and expenditure method. Already you people have done the first method, that is value added method. So today, I am going to explain you income method. Children, income method is also called as factor payment method. According to this method, national income is estimated in terms of factor payment, that is compensation of employees, rent, interest and profit to the owners of factors of production, that is labor, land, capital and enterprise during an accounting year. Now here you people know very well that households are the owners of factors of production. So while estimating national income, only those households are considered who are the normal resident of a country. So children, national income is actually estimated as the sum of total of factor income earned by the normal resident of the country during an accounting year. So the total factor income which is generated within the domestic territory of a country is called domestic income. And in this domestic income, if we add the net factor income from abroad, and so we get national income. Now the thing come, what is factor income? Though already I've explained you in the previous chapter, factor income, children, actually is the income which is being earned by a person as a reward for the service rendered by him. Now it may be in the form of wage or salary for his labor, let's say rent for his land, interest for his capital or profit for his entrepreneurship. Here you have to remember one thing, that it is only the earned income which has been included in national income, not the not earned income. Means the income for which no factor service has been rendered, that is not included for the estimation of national income. For example, let's say old age pension. Now this old age pension which has been actually received by the senior citizen of a country, which has been paid by the government, is not a earned income. It's a kind of a help which has been given by the government to a senior citizen for which they do not render any service. So children, such payment are called transfer payment or transfer receipts, and they are not to be included in the estimation of national income. Now when national income is being estimated by income method, so here there are certain classification of the factor income, and let's see what are those classification of factor incomes. The first one is the compensation employees, under which we have wages and salaries in cash, payments in kind, employees' contribution to social security and pension on retirement. Second, we include operating surplus. When we talk about operating surplus, under which we have rent, interest and profit, and profit is further classified as dividend, corporate or corporation profit tax and undistributed profit. And the third one is the mixed income. Now let me explain you each in detail. So the first one is compensation of employees. Now under compensation of employees, it includes certain components which are wages and salaries in cash, means cash which has been paid or transferred to the salary account of the employees by the employer, which is a reward for the work done during an accounting year. Then second under this is payments in kind, that it refers to the kind of a benefit which has been received by the employees in the form of a kind by the employer. For example, you can say a rent-free accommodation, then employees' contribution to social security. It means, children, a payment. Such payment, which is, let's say, as a provident fund contribution by the employees on behalf of the employees. Remember, employees, okay, on behalf of the employees. Then the pension retirement, a very important and a very specific over here. It refers, children, not to an old age pension, remember. In fact, it refers to a pension payment as a part of service contract between the employer and the employees. Means here we do not include old age pension. Rather, we include that pension which is actually a service contract between the employer and employee. That once the employee will be retired, then he will get a part of it, which is actually for which actually he has rendered his service. Then the next is an operating surplus. It includes the income from property and entrepreneurship, which, as I told you, includes rent, interest and profit. You already know what is rent, you know interest. When we talk about profit, children, profit is further split into three components. First is dividend. Now, dividend is actually a part of the profit which is distributed among the shareholders. Now, here you have to remember that it is also known as distributed profit. So when you are going to do the numericals on income method, there you have to remember that if it is distributed profit, it has to be included. Then we have corporate or corporation profit tax, means that part of a profit which is actually paid to the government in the form of profit tax. Then we have undistributed profit. Undistributed profit is that profit which is actually kept by the firms for the future use. Let's say for their for meeting some of their contingent expenses, and it is also known by the name of corporate saving or undistributed profit. So children, all these terms have to be known by you. They have to be thoroughly known to you so that once you do the numericals, you do not face any problem that which items are to be included. Then that last one is the children mixed income, which has been included under income method for estimating national income. So when we talk about mixed income actually refer to the income of self-employed person. Now when we say self-employed person, means a person who is using his own labor, his own land, his own capital, and he himself is an entrepreneurship. So it's an household enterprise, right? So here it's very difficult, you know, these income, that is wages, rent, interest and profit, they all are mixture. And that is why it is called mixed income. And it is very difficult to separate the estimation of wages or rent or interest or profit, which is actually not possible. Because, you know, over here, the factors of production are neither hired nor purchased, nor they are purchased from the market. So when they are not hired and when they are not purchased, and a self-employed person is actually playing the role of all four factors of production, so it becomes difficult to categorize the income into different category, and that is the reason we say it's a mixed income. So as already I have told you that factor income is actually generated from within the domestic territory of our country, which is called NDP at factor cost, that is net domestic product at factor cost, or you can simply say it's a domestic income. So if we have to reach to the national income, so within the domestic income, what do we add? In this NDP at factor cost, we add NFIA, that is net factor income from abroad, and we get NNP at factor cost, or you can also say national income. So children, these are the different components which comes under the income method. So for calculating national income by income method, all these different types of components are to be kept in mind.